Despite the fallout from this exploding airbag crisis, Takata's CFO says the company continues to be financially stable. He made those comments at the company's headquarters here in Tokyo, where they also announced they are slashing their full-year profit forecast by 75%, down from 20 billion yen to 5 billion yen. That's just a quarter of what they were estimating a few months ago. When you look at the stock performance for the year, it's down 43%. And the list of major customers ditching Takata continues to grow. Mitsubishi, Mazda, Honda, and now Toyota saying they will no longer use Takata airbag inflators if they contain the volatile compound ammonium nitrate, though they will consider using other inflators. We saw the danger of these exploding inflators firsthand when we visited a scrapyard 3 hours from Tokyo. Before these cars are stripped, crushed, sold for scrap, Japanese junkyard workers deploy the airbags. These photos show the terrifying danger, damage caused by exploding airbags from Japanese car parts maker Takata, just like the ones that end up in Nobuhiro Chikamatsu's scrapyard. We're just lucky our staff wasn't hurt, he says. He's been documenting airbag explosions for several years, powerful blasts turning inflators like this into jagged metal projectiles.
Workers say the force of one of the explosions was so powerful, it actually shot a piece of metal up 10 meters, about 33 feet, leaving that hole in the ceiling.
Chikamatsu says his scrapyard alone has seen 4 airbag explosions in the last several years, each car around 10 years old with airbags made by Takata.
Those airbags confirmed to be responsible for 8 deaths and dozens of injuries. U.S. regulators have slapped Takata with $70 million in fines, and the company could have to pay another $130 million if they don't improve their safety practices. Meanwhile, they're having a hard time keeping up with the demand for replacement parts. There are still millions of cars on the road right now with airbags that need to be fixed, which means there are millions of drivers unsure if they're safe. Will Ripley, CNN, Tokyo.